Hey Leo, this is your sacred scribe here, ready to do your Monday, July 20th to the 21st intuitive love tarot read. This is for my Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Jupiter in North Node. This will not resonate with everybody, of course, but hopefully it will with you guys today. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe right down below there, Leo, if you would, before you leave. I do appreciate it. And thank you so much for all of your likes, shares, and subscriptions. If you guys are interested in a personal reading with me, that way this is more specific to you and your questions and your needs, the information can be found in the description box below. All right, Leo, I'm going to pull a couple cards here, and then I'm going to get a channeled message for you from Spirit. If you're interested, I posted a video earlier today because I had a UFO sighting experience on the freaking highway in broad daylight. So literally UFOs, I say that plural, yes, because they were tiny. They were about this big. They were not drones. I saw them right in front of my face, right next to my car. No noise, no like exhaust or anything. There was like 10 of them in a cluster, and they just flew over my truck, and I'm like, holy fuck. So I came back, and I was about to do a private reading, and Spirit said, nope, you have to do a reading about your experience today. I said, okay. So cleared up why they are here. So a lot of information is in that video. They talk about manifestation as well. It's an oracle reading. They didn't want me to use tarot cards, so that's what I got, man. And what's more interesting is I've been waiting. I haven't checked in the last couple hours I've been doing readings, but I've been waiting to see if this was going to be on the news, because there's no way I was the only person that saw that. Literally right outside the side of my window, like right there. It's like if you were standing up and it was flying about that high above my truck. That's how close. It was a very clear picture of what they were. And then Spirit showed me, this was funny, the Men in Black, if you remember, the little tiny spaceship with the little tiny alien that was in it, that's what they showed me. So I thought that was kind of funny. But so far, I haven't been able to find it on the news. I've been Googling, because I don't watch TV. I don't even have cable. So I've just been Googling, looking at NBC, ABC, you know, whatever. Because there's no way I was the only one who freaking seen that. And I know that there's been sightings in other states. I think it was last week, I was watching Marfugel, and he had mentioned something about that in Washington State. He had said that people were saying that they were clusters of drones, but I'm telling you right now, it's not freaking drones. I know what a drone is. I love drones, actually. I don't have one, but I've seen enough of them to know it's not a freaking drone. But they saw these clusters of drones, as they called them, go into like a ship, right? As if they were like reporting back, which is basically true from what Spirit told me, why they're here and what they're doing. So anyway, that's posted if you're interested. Let me get one more card, and then I'm going to get a channeled message for you from Spirit. Okay, so we have the 10 of Swords, Leo. We have the 5 of Wands. We have the 6 of Swords. We have the 3 of Wands. And we have, the Wheel of Fortune at the bottom of the deck. Destiny is involved, Leo. All right, so let's get this message from Spirit and see what is up for you. They're saying, let your inner being be your guide, not your turmoil. For some of you, you may be going through something right now that's giving you inner turmoil. You've got to stop that and listen to your intuition. You've got to try to clear that energy, because somehow this turmoil that you're experiencing may guide you down the wrong path, and they're wanting you to be aware of this. Okay, they just said get to the reading because there's more information. Interesting. Okay. So now you've got the Five of Wands over the Ten of Swords. So you could have recently been betrayed, been lied to, backstabbed, right? See, with the Five of Wands, there's like, it could have been fighting with like a group of people, right? And there's something at a distance. It's like you're waiting for something at a distance. You wanting peace. You're wanting to move away from this inner turmoil. So let's clarify. But this is all due to your destiny and your path. And this is why I feel that they're asking you to be careful of this, because there is some destiny involved and they're not wanting you to veer off of this. The Empress is clarifying the Five of Wands. Okay, you could be competing for this Empress, because this is competition with like four other people, and this may be hurting you. But Ten of Swords is more betrayal. Let me see. Who is this Empress to Leo? This could also be your mother. Six of Pentacles. This is a mother. A mother figure. I feel like this person betrayed you. They're saying, yeah. Okay, so this Empress betrayed you. I'm feeling like this Empress was selfish, actually. With the Six of Pentacles, she or he may have been giving to more than one person. And you found this out. So, Ten of Swords. This is leading you away from wherever you're at. Yeah. Four of Swords. You had to do some healing. Sorry, I thought my iPad was going to fall, as it does so often. So the Four of Swords is telling me that you've been doing some healing regarding this situation. You peaced out, which is a good thing. Okay. Ten of Wands. Yeah, this has been a burden. What are you waiting for? What is at a distance? What's at a distance? You get a soulmate from a past life at a distance from you that you're waiting for? Sagittarius energy. You or them could have Sagittarius in their charts. Now this is... Temperance is about balance, right? It's also about embracing change. So they're wanting you to find your balance. I do feel like the soulmate is your destiny, but you're needing to focus more in the spiritual than the material here, Leo. That's very important. And you've got to let this past shit go. Okay. From this past relationship. Tell me about the Six of Swords. Now, this could have been a relationship with a family member, right, who betrayed you. Three of Cups. This could have involved a third party situation. But I also feel like this Six of Cups here, it's like you're reuniting with the past life soulmate. Eight of Cups. Yeah. See, now you're walking away from this third party situation, right? That's ended. And you could literally be moving with the Three of... Okay. Let's see where you're going. Where's Leo going? Let's see. Where's Leo going? Where is Leo? My beautiful Leo's going. Where are my Leos going? This is your wish. Yes. This is also talking about confidence and hope. Okay, something that's written in the stars for you. I told you it's destiny. Could be a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn that you're going towards, but that's where you're going. They just said settle down. The Queen of Pentacles is the shit, right? She's like right under the Empress, where she's whatever she builds is awesome. It's like she builds legacies, not just businesses. If you notice with the Pentacle, right? She's building something, but she's really appreciating what she's building. Like the King of Pentacles is not even looking at his pentacle. She is like nurturing it, and really it thrives because of the heart that she puts into it. And I feel like you see this. This is your wish come true. This is a past life soulmate, and this is your destiny, Leo. So it's like your turmoil that you're coming from, whether this be romantic or family oriented, is going to be worth it. Is going to be worth it because it's leading you to someplace beautiful. Advice. I love that Six of Cups energy. It's so innocent. It's so childlike. It's beautiful. Seven of Cups. Don't stop dreaming. Don't let this turmoil guide you. You've got to keep your dreams alive here. Don't let it confuse you, okay? Know that you can create despite. Yes. Don't be stuck, okay? Utilize this time to look at the situation from a different perspective. Know that you can manifest again. Keep your heart open with the Queen of Cups here. Okay? If you listen to my UFO video, they talk about manifesting and keeping your heart open, which is very interesting to me. So, the bottom of the deck, oh my God, that I told you this is your destiny. This was at the beginning. Okay? Talk about confirmation. I mean, there's freaking 78 cards in this deck. Right? All right, Leo. I hope this helped. Please drop a like below, share and subscribe if you already haven't, if you're interested in a personal reading with me. That way this is more specific to you and your needs and your questions. The information can be found in the description box below. Have yourself a good one, Leo, and I'll talk to you tomorrow. Namaste.